Music delights and intrigues the mind through the ears. No one's able to say quite how music works, what it does, what it affects in us. I believe it is that it physically affects different regions of the brain simultaneously, multiplying the pleasure it inspires in humans and in animals alike. Lucy loves music.
Yes, my love.
There's something about photography, more so even than drawing or painting, that is capable of eliciting similar response in human beings. Magic Iron was sent to me in a dream. For weeks, I've been trying to print gold using an old process. But the results, time after time, when I got anything at all, were grainy, gritty, and red. They were useless. Finally, in disgust, I just gave up. I said, to hell with this. I took the chemicals, put them in a box, took that box upstairs, and shelved it in my walk-in closet. Went downstairs, and I got on the internet, and I ordered the chemicals for printing with palladium. Even though I had done all that, I still didn't give it up, though. I couldn't let go. I started getting depressed, and I started thinking about all sorts of different ways I might improve printing with gold, different things I could do. But finally, the palladium arrived. And I went to bed that night, resolved the next day I would print in palladium. And that's when the dream came, a dream of gold and iron being refined. I dreamt there were two sluices. Through one of the sluices was flowing molten iron, and through the other, molten gold. And the two sluices emptied the metals into a cauldron. As I looked on that cauldron and saw the two metals mixing together and forming an alloy, glowing red hot, my dream voice announced to me, "That is magic iron." I'm holding up the two chemicals that constitute the magic iron in Magic Iron Rose. One is a light-sensitive iron-based chemical, ammonium ferric oxalate. You dissolve it in water, expose it to sunlight or UV light, a chemical reaction occurs, and the iron is changed and it can no longer stay in the suspension and drops out. It sounds light-sensitive. It doesn't sound like much, but it does work with a form of palladium chloride to get an image to form on hydrated paper. Now this is vitamin C, ascorbic acid. This is the stuff you buy in the grocery store, the granola stores, drug stores. It's white powder, you dissolve it in water. Then you add some of that solution to a solution of the ammonium ferric oxalate, and you get a super sensitive, supercharged chemical that lets you print out things like these pictures behind me. These are all chrysotypes, gold prints, Texas chrysotypes. They're beautiful. You can see them. They're not red. They're not grainy. They're not gritty like the other chrysotypes you make. This sarcophagus in the San Fernando Cathedral in San Antonio de Bejar, Texas, contains the remains of Bowie, Crockett, and Travis, the three commanders at the Alamo. The quality of the Texas chrysotype process is so high you can actually see the three figures on the sarcophagus and read the words Texas Heroes. And it works with the rose in Magic Iron Rose, rhodium, as I'm going to demonstrate. In the summer of 2014, 2 years ago, I invented several new processes in which I would partially develop out an image using a noble metal such as gold, iridium or rhodium, and then develop that image out fully with silver nitrate. The last one on which I worked was rhodium. And when I finished, I had 3 drops exactly of 10% rhodium solution left. I thought, well, I've been partially printing this out now for weeks. Why don't I see if I can print out a full image in pure rhodium? So I mixed up those 3 drops of rhodium with 3 drops of magic iron, brushed it on a sheet of paper, let it dry, made my contact print. And what I got was a photograph, the first and only so far ever, in pure rhodium. You can see it's brownish, somewhat contrasty, but not bad. It's comparable to some platinum prints you might see if they were developed out with a high temperature developer, which makes it rather grainy. And this is a series of strips of paper I've cut from larger sheets. Each of these is pure red cotton. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to mix together 3-4 drops of rhodium with 3-4 drops of magic iron, swirl it together. Then I'm going to take an eyedropper and just put a little splotch on each one. There we go. There. Now they're all coated. What I'm going to do is let them dry, and then I'm going to expose them to UV light.
I'm burning the paper in my UV setup.
Some of the strips are showing a red-brown, but that's just the way they dried on the paper. That is no indicator of reduction of rhodium salt to elemental rhodium. This is puzzling. I would have expected some reduction on at least one of these. They're all red cotton paper. There's no sizing to interfere with the rhodium. So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to try hydrating the paper. That's a process whereby you waste, 50 gallons of precious water by taking a sheet of paper on which you're going to print. You place it in the bathroom, turn on your shower, and let it run for half an hour. And when the paper is nice and damp, you coat it, let the sensitizer dry while trying to keep the paper still damp. And then when you're done, you try to print it out. I think I have a clothes steamer in the closet I bought 5 years ago that helps it along. So I'm going to try that. Next, I'm going to try hydrating with pure rhodium. Results were not what I'd hoped. Paper's good and wet. It's nice and hydrated. However, I got just the slightest reduction of rhodium salt to elemental rhodium. There's some gray in here. Very minimal. If I were to take this now and develop it out fully with silver nitrate, there would be almost no rhodium in the final image. There's just not enough there to contribute to the silver. That didn't work, in other words. What's next? Next, silver nitrate itself is light sensitive. So I'm going to try something I've never tried before. I'm going to try mixing silver nitrate with ammonium ferrous oxalate, magic iron. I've got on chicken gloves. Chicken, because I'm going to be working with silver nitrate. Silver nitrate is some nasty stuff. Gets on anything organic, it oxidizes, tarnishes, and turns black, and turns whatever it's on black. And your skin, for example, will stay black until the cells die and slough off, which can take weeks. So, I'm doing this because I tried to get rhodium chloride to reduce, release the chloride as chlorine gas and become pure elemental rhodium and drop down in the paper. Didn't work. I'm going to have to think about that. Maybe I'll have a dream and solve the problem. But at any rate, until that time, I'm moving on. And today I'm going to count out 4 drops of magic iron into a shot glass. Then I'm going to count into a shot glass 4 drops of rhodium. And then to that I'm going to add 2 drops of silver nitrate. The idea being, I'm hoping that the silver nitrate will act as a catalyst and further the reduction of the rhodium to its elemental state. I've got paper. I've got my brush for spreading the sensitizer onto the paper. I've got my shot glass to receive the liquids. I've got rhodium, magic iron, and in here, out of the light, freshly mixed silver nitrate. First, magic iron. 4 drops. Then, now I'll add the rhodium. I'm just going to use, there we go, 4 drops of rhodium. Swirl that together. And now, I need, I better pull this out. Let's see. I need an eyedropper. There we go. This is the silver. Uh-oh. Well, that doesn't look so good.
That's not good at all.
Well, that was embarrassing. As soon as the silver nitrate hit the magic iron and the rhodium, it precipitated out of solution. Oh, God. In Sonnets to Orpheus, Rilke wrote, "Ist der Trinken bitter, wer der Wein." Clearly, he didn't know about tequila, especially not 100 proof organic tequila, or he would have written Verde tequila, because it is a hell of a lot sweeter than rhodium chloride. What I'm thinking I'm going to do now, since I'm not having a hell of a lot of luck with pure rhodium again, is try working out the optimal formula for printing out rhodium mixed with gold or platinum or palladium and or iridium. I reason if I get a print that's at least 51% rhodium, the remainder any other metal, it's a rhodiotype. I'm going to get right on that as soon as I finish this bath and sober up.
Rosa, reiner Widerspruch. Lust niemand schlaft zu sein unter so viel Liedern.
I'll print this rhodium no matter what it takes. I made a little contact print, 4x5, rhodium and gold. A little contrasty. Maybe I didn't expose it. So, I'm a sucker for anything just lying around the house, and I had a roll of, silk, pure silk, made from worms, doing whatever worms do to make silk. And I immersed a piece of it in a sensitizer that consisted of 2/3 rhodium and 1/3 gold with magic iron, and I got this. It's interesting, to say the least. It's the only thing like its type ever made and ever will be made. So, Fabriano Artistico, 2/3 rhodium, 1/3 gold. The model's really nice. The face, the hair, all that, beautiful. The problem is, in the really dense areas where the D-Max is, the black dress and so forth, there's some solarization going on. As well as still a little bit too much contrast. The problem with rhodium and gold alone is that combination is too contrasting. Now, there are 3 ways you can lower contrast. Use less ascorbic acid in the magic iron, or use a lower contrast paper, or add another metal that has a wide tonal range, that is to say, that is a low contrast metal when it prints out. I've already tried playing around with different substrates. I'm tired of that. And I'm not going to mix up still more magic iron when I have magic iron that's working perfectly. Well, so I decided I would add palladium to rhodium and gold, and this is what I got. It's a beautiful print. It's got beautiful contrast. It's a beautiful image overall. It's only got one problem, and that problem, I've decided, is the gold. It's got no real D-Max. But where there is deep shadow, it's got a purple stain to it. Gold. So I'm going to try this. Palladium and rhodium. I bet you I get contrast falling through the floor.
What you're looking at is low contrast rhodium with palladium. This is about 52% rhodium and the remainder palladium, and it's quite flat and got no Dmax.
I got so frustrated trying to print rhodium and failing that I do what I always do when I get frustrated. I got drunk, this time on tequila, white tequila. In my tequila-induced dream, I dreamt I was trying to print a white rose. But the problem was the rose would not stay flat on the paper. It would not stay an image. It would keep coming to life, rising out of the paper. I couldn't get it to print it. But in my dream logic, I realized if I took a hot iron and hot pressed that rose flat, I would be able to make an image with it. I decided I would print right away. I knew I would print a negative of a white rose, but I did not know on which paper. And I went into my walk-in closet, and I looked through my papers, and I ran my fingers over them until I felt one that seemed right, and I lifted it up and looked at it and examined its watermark. And it was Arche Platine, white, hot press paper. I knew I had the paper that would print rhodium. I exposed a negative in 4x5 of a white rose. I then took that into my dark room and I enlarged it to 10 inches square. Not a big degree of enlargement, not much loss of quality, in fact, none. I'm going to print with this and put this away. Now I'm going to print on Arche Platine paper, white, rag cotton, and pour it out towards the center. I'm going to hold some back. And you brush quickly, because if you don't brush it quickly, it will stain the paper, and which means it will stain the image. You'll have an area in the image that's a dark splotch. Time to check. You can see the overbrushed area is getting quite dark. I'm going to drop the bottom and examine it. And here is the image. A rose. 10 inches by 10 inches. Let me see if I can bring it in closer for you. Here you have a rhodiotype. What I'm going to do with this right now is take it upstairs. I have waiting for it a tray of 5% hydrochloric acid. I'm going to dissolve as much of the palladium as possible. At this moment, the print is 75% rhodium, and the rest, the remaining 25%, palladium and iridium. When I'm done, it should be about 85% rhodium. The rhodiotype of the rose, the magic iron rose. When documentary's over, my roses have gone to join Théophile Gautier's Spectre de la Rose in the eponymous ballet. I'm out of tequila. What am I going to drink? And I'm almost out of rhodium. What's next for me?